so many people in America see college sports as an extension, a very nostalgic extension of high school sports,
right.
where the quarterback and a cheerleader have a romance and they celebrate their victory over the rivals at a malt shop. It's not that. It's a $6 billion a year industry. Last year, CBS and TBS split up $1 billion just off of March Madness. There's so much money being made, and the people who are creating this wealth do not get to participate, but they don't get to graduate, and that's a big issue.
We have to keep, a good perspective on this. Obviously, we're talking here about football and men's basketball, but if we're going to start paying the football players, we have to pay the field hockey players, and we have to pay the men and women swimmers, and we have to pay the lacrosse players, softball players,
Why?
Baseball players, because there's something known as Title IX, Newt, signed by Richard Nixon, June 23rd, 1972, that mandates proportional, equal treatment under the law, no discrimination, when you're giving out federal funds for men and women, whether it be med schools, law schools, or sports. And there is no doubt in my mind that the moment, if we started to just pay football players and men's basketball players, you would have 12 lawsuits the first day, and you'd have 12 the next day, and every school would be sued because of this wonderful law, which I think the nation has embraced, the most important law, I think, in our country the last 41 years, Title IX, from your own party, Richard Nixon. And I think that's something that we have to keep in mind. So it sounds real simple, but when you start to break it down, these universities don't want to do this because of the legal possibilities.
The problem with that is, all right, the guys on the water polo team or some of the other teams, the swimming team, the diamond team, they don't generate any revenue. If you look at the revenue, the people that come to sit in the stands when they're competing, very few, they don't pay a lot of dollars. Football and basketball are on national TV. They generate money for all of these national sponsors and advertisers. It's incredible how much money is being made. The president of the NCAA makes $1.7 million a year, yet the people who are performing and generating this cash do not get to participate in any way. And if they get hurt or anything, a lot of times they lose their scholarship. They don't even get to graduate. They have to pay their own way through school. I think that's a travesty, and something needs to be done about it.